About 10 years ago, a group of researchers from the Department of Civil Engineering at Makerere University and the University of Cape Town in South Africa published a report titled Slope Stability and Settlement Characteristics of Mpere Landfill. The study shed light on the challenges posed by the landfill's slope stability and settlement behavior. It highlighted the need for urgent intervention. They likened Chitezi to the Payatas landfill in the Philippines, which killed at least 330 people in July 2020 after 2 weeks of heavy rain. Bernard Waswa, one of the researchers, said, "Even after this regrettable disaster, there is a need for the government to procure a monitoring system to periodically measure the slopes which had cracks at the landfill." Following a presidential directive on the Chitezi landfill slide tragedy that has so far claimed 21 lives, the government has started demarcating the danger zones. Hajat Minsa Kabanda, Minister for Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Affairs, yesterday revealed that they resolved to start demarcating the danger zones and all those in the hotspots areas will be relocated.
Now, at this time, after the meeting, because you've seen the meeting, but right now they've gone to demarcate. And after the demarcation, all those are going to be located somewhere. That's why we are telling them, if you have nowhere to go, if you don't have money, you go to the tent until further notice. At least for a week, then you look for somewhere to go.
This decision was reached during a meeting with the Inspector General of Police, Abbas Biakagawa, Works Minister General Katumba Wamala, and State Minister for Disaster, Lilian Abe, among others. Patrick Ola Lumumba, the Bartegela AP Division Mayor, whose division is expected to host the maiden regional parliamentary sittings in Gulu City from August 28th to 30th, has asked the parliament to compensate them for 1 billion shillings for non-remitted discretionary development equalization grant since the city's inception in 2020. During an interview with Vision Group, Lumumba added that the regional parliamentary sitting is a waste of time and resources.
We are not even interested in welcoming them. And we are going to put it very clear that if they are coming to Gulu City, they are coming to Bartegela Ibi, and they have not yet given the funding which was to be given to Bartegela Ibi, let them not come. The first thing we want is 1 billion shilling compensation for what we have lost. I'm not even asking for the new area, which was covered as. So the money they are going to waste in tents, construction, those are the money they should give directly to support the city division.
However, Dr. Abed Buanika, the chairperson of the Government Assurance Committee, responded to Lumumba's concerns, saying that the decision to reduce discretionary development equalization grant for newly created city divisions was due to policy formulation and implementation.
There are serious issues in funding the new cities. First of all, we need to work on the law for cities. We are now working under Local Government Act, and that has created problems. We need a specific law for cities. We need to work on the funding. Municipalities cannot be funded as a sub-county.
Rwanda's President Paul Kagame was sworn in yesterday for the fourth term, saying regional peace was a priority in the face of ongoing conflict in the neighboring Democratic Republic of Congo. Kagame swept to victory in elections last month with a staggering 99.18% of the vote, giving him another 5 years in office. Several dozens of heads of states and other dignitaries from the African nations joined the inauguration ceremony at a packed 45,000-seat stadium in Kigali, where many were dressed in green, yellow, and blue colors of the Rwandan national flag. Kagame took oath of office before Justice Faustin Ntezeyayo, pledging to preserve peace and national sovereignty and consolidate national unity.